Trump upset victory divinely sent to begin messianic process, say Israeli rabbis, right?
Before the 2016 presidential election, some evangelical Christians began comparing Donald Trump to King Cyrus, the biblical king who's credited with allowing Jews to return to Jerusalem from exile in the Babylonian Empire. The idea behind the comparison is that a non-believing leader can be used by God to enact policies that help advance the interests of believers, in this case, Christians and Jews.
We will move the American embassy to the eternal capital of the Jewish people, Jerusalem.
Donald Trump recognized history. He, like King Cyrus before him, fulfilled the biblical prophecy of the gods worshipped by Jews, Christians, and yes, Muslims, that Jerusalem is the eternal capital of the Jewish state.
I have determined that it is time to officially recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel.
I think President Trump has made history. This will be remembered the way we remember the Cyrus Declaration from 2,500 years ago when he told the exiles of Babylon, you can go back and rebuild the temple in Jerusalem. This is a historic moment and we will always remember it.
Good day, brothers and sisters. You've seen the video clip before that. That is just to give you some food for thought there concerning the subject. The two messiahs, Mashiach ben Joseph and Mashiach ben David. Now you see two familiar presidents on here and you probably wonder, this guy is talking bull. No. What's the video? It's not according to your interpretation. You have to look at the whole subject concerning who is the false prophet and who is the Antichrist according to what the Jews believe. Remember, Jacob's trouble is for the Jews, not for the Muslims, not for it's not that it just says it's not for them, but it is particularly for the Jews because, look, Israel, the Jews do serve God, but they do not believe that Jesus Christ is the Messiah. So God is going to deal with them. After the rapture, God is going to deal with Israel again. Now, the Jews do believe in two messiahs, and we're coming to that subject. Okay, yeah, the two messiahs, Ben Joseph, Donald Trump, and Ben David, Barack Obama. In order to understand this teaching, we need to understand who Mashiach Ben Joseph is and where he fits into the rabbinic biblical eschatology. To get this, we need to find out three things. What does the Tanakh say about who is Messiah? What do the rabbis mean by Messiah. Where do the rabbis get the idea of more than one Messiah? The rabbis believe in two Messiahs, one exalted and one suffering. It is not two Messiahs, one exalted and one suffering, but one Messiah. Now that is difficult to understand at first. But if you look at my previous video about a satanic trinity, you will do understand that it is one God. There's three persons and it's one God. So here is two persons, but it's still one Messiah. First time is suffering and second time exalted. Now I'm not going to deal with the subject in detail. It's going to be too much information. However, I'm going to give you the summary of Rabbi Tovia Singer's video. I will pin the link and the detail for you in the comment section. The two messiahs. A certain rabbi identified as Horowitz had set a date for the messiah's arrival 300 years ago on the Jewish calendar. He said it in the year 5777. We all know the famous 5777. We had a lot of discussions about that, which translates as somewhere in between 2016 and 2017. And this rabbi, yeah, his prophecy really came to pass here. It so happened that Donald Trump stood for president and he became the president in 2016 and he was inaugurated in 2017. Now they're looking at Donald Trump. One of the rabbis illustrated how his name, the numerology of his name, actually means Messiah. There have been at least a dozen Jewish rabbis that has said the Messiah is on earth now. He has been identified. He is soon going to make himself known. Well, in some way or other, these two do give hints that they are the Antichrist and the false prophet. Now we must understand the false prophet. Most of you say the false prophet is the Pope. He's not the Pope. Everything that you've learned about the Antichrist and the false prophet comes from the elite's propaganda. But what is a false prophet, the prophet anyway? A prophet is a spokesman, and this man is the spokesman for the Antichrist. There have been, as I said, there have been at least a dozen Jewish rabbis that have said the Messiah is on earth and he has been identified. We all know that the Antichrist can only identify himself, reveal himself, once the bride of Christ is gone. The Messiah is seen differently in Jewish culture compared to Christian culture. Now the two messiahs, they're looking for a king. They are looking for a political, that is the Jews. They are looking for a king. They are looking for a political leader. And so a matter of fact, Messiah to them means anointed one. And it goes back to the ancient days when they would anoint a king, you remember King Saul, and recognize him as this is the man that God sent. They are looking for somebody in the political figure who can lead decisive battles, who can lead decisive battles in defense of Israel. This is why the only politician, Donald Trump, on the face of the earth was standing up and saying, if I am elected president, I am going to be the biggest friend Israel ever had. We are going to undo the Iran deal and being a friend of Benjamin Netanyahu. You must understand that everything is planned by the elite, even in Obama's time concerning the Iran deal. And it was already discussed that Donald Trump, when he comes to power, that he will undo the Iran deal as to make them believe that he is really standing for Israel. But I have to tell you, this man will betray Israel in the abomination. Yes, Donald Trump will, the anti-spirit will betray Israel, and he will cause the abomination. Oh, Daniel. Yes, now the rabbi, this rabbi predicted Trump will win and usher in the second coming. In two separate sets of biblical codes published 3 months apart, international Bible codes expert Rabbi Matityahu Glazerson shows evidence he has found that declares Donald J. Trump will win the presidential election. Trump's victory, Glazerson said, is directly connected to his support for Israel. Glazerson also found codes that point to both November 8 and November 9, the date of the election, and the first day Trump would be president-elect if he wins. The rabbi quotes the book of Isaiah 45 and the story of Cyrus, which has been frequently referenced by evangelical faith leaders, by believers in Christ himself, and the Jews who have supported the Republican presidential nominee. So there you have it. It is what the Jews are thinking, their thought in it. And that is where you need to search for who the Antichrist and the false prophet is. Okay? So here, the Jewish rabbis, they quote Isaiah 45, and Donald Trump is the 45th president of the United, Ahmed, or 45th president of the United States. And they relate the story of Cyrus. And they are very much in love with Trump. The evangelicals love Donald Trump. Believers in Christ do love Donald Trump, and the Jews love Donald Trump. So you have a perfect combination. Now you say, yes, Obama, Israel will never accept him. Yes, you'll see a surprise. It's not about accepting him. Obama is the Antichrist. Donald Trump is not the Antichrist, but the anti-spirit. He is the false prophet. The Pope is not the false prophet. As I say it again, many of you believe that the Pope is the false prophet. He is not the false prophet. Please watch my video, view my video about the final kingdom of Satan, the four beasts, and the final kingdom of Satan. Please do watch that video. The false prophet belonged to the fourth beast, the war. That is where the Pope belonged to. Now, another rabbi from Breaking News Israel, a mystic rabbi living in southern Israel, is urging all Jews, that was of course with the blood moon, he asked them to pray and repent as the third blood moon or the tetrad approaches. We all know where that already happened. One of Rabbi Vakin's student, Jill Nacton, spoke to Breaking Israel News and quoting the saints, explaining that the numeric value of the Hebrew word for blood, dam, which is 44th, alluded to the to Obama, the 44th president of the United States. So Yeah, as I said, you have to look at the viewpoint from the viewpoint of the Jews and the rabbis. That is what they are believing in, and they will be deceived. They will get the Antichrist. Modern Jews in general do not believe the Messiah has come. To Jews, Jesus, Yeshua, was simply a teacher who in his day and since his day has had a very exceptional influence, but he was not considered the Messiah. However, many Jews and Christians are anxiously awaiting the moment when Messiah will arrive. But of course, that is at the second coming. We all know that Jesus, Yeshua, will fetch his bride in the clouds. And those that didn't accept, that didn't walk with the Lord during the time of, by the time that we are warning you, you will remain behind with the Antichrist. Yeah, for Christians, it will be the second coming, and for Jews, his first. Not only are Jews awaiting the Messiah, but they are also awaiting the arrival of a second Messiah who will precede. Did you hear that? Did you hear that? You will say, yes, they will never receive Donald Trump, but the one they do love, the one that they do see as their Messiah, possible Messiah, will precede Ben David. Ben Joseph comes first. Not only are the Jews awaiting, but they are also waiting the arrival, and repeat it again, the arrival of the second Messiah, the one who will precede first, but will be second in rank of the two Messiahs. Yeah, the Jews refer to the primary Messiah as Messiah Ben David. Sometimes referred, he is the primary one, the first one. Remember, sometimes referred as the Messiah Ben Judah or King Messiah. This Messiah will descend from the lineage of King David, and his genealogy is from King David. He also has his lineage from the Assyrian. He fits all of them. Donald Trump is of Ephraim, and he is from the tribe of Dan. The secondary Messiah was referred by the Jews as Messiah Ben Joseph. Now, I like to put people in there, what's his name, so that you can describe it as best as possible for you. For me, it gives you extra feeling. So the secondary Messiah was referred by the Jews as Messiah Ben Joseph, sometimes referred to as Messiah Ben Ephraim. And did you know that America is Ephraim? America is Ephraim. Remember the prophecy of Jacob when he blessed Ephraim and Manasseh? He crossed his hands. Yeah. Ben Joseph is from Ephraim. Ephraim does not symbolize some modern entity or nation, but represents the 10 tribes of Israel. It is more than possible that Donald Trump is from one of the 10 lost tribes known collectively as Ephraim. And America is Ephraim. Ephraim in itself, from the tribe, that there are many tribes of Israel in America. America has the most population, the greatest population of Jews in the world. Messiah comes from a Hebrew word meaning anointed one, and Ben translated as a son or son or of, as Messiah Ben Joseph would render as the anointed one of Joseph. So you will see, he will be the forerunner in the first 3.5 years of the tribulation. He will be the foremost person there, and he will be almost like, say, taking the back seat in the first 3.5 years, although he does sign the agreement. The Antichrist is the one that signed the agreement, the peace agreement with Israel. So he is mostly to the forefront, and as we know from the Revelation 13, he is the one that will create miracles, cause fire to come from the sky, and I believe there will be a real contest between the two witnesses, especially with Elijah, the two witnesses that are coming. Okay, so the suffering Messiah, son of Joseph, the messianic interpretation of Isaiah 53 was common before the during the days of Jesus or Yeshua. The New Testament writers, most of them were Jewish, address this in at least 7 passages. That is Matthew 8:17, Mark 15:28, Luke 22:37, John 12:37, verse 38, Acts 8:32-33, Romans 10:16, and 1 Peter 2:24-7. You go through that scriptures yourself. It continued during the creation of the Talmud, which was finished around 400 AD. Many other ancient Jewish writings support the view that Isaiah 53 is the messianic passage. We do as well. According to David C. Mitchell, Ben Joseph will begin by gathering a following in Galilee. So we need to watch out for this. Donald Trump's visitation to the Holy Land. And this is what the Jews is expecting, and is writing according to what they will expect. And I believe this is how it is going to happen. Some say, yes, it will be his son-in-law is the Antichrist. I don't think so. Publicly, it says that this man is the Antichrist. His name is Lightning, and he's been addressed in the Bible as such. Ben Joseph then will be killed. Remember, there are many dreams and many prophecies that states that Donald Trump will be assassinated or killed. According to Mitchell, this happened in Israel, where he will be killed. I guess you need to watch the space. Keep a watch on Donald Trump's verses to Israel. Now, the following point summarizes teaching and agreed to in the Midrash that deals with the Mashiach ben Joseph and Mashiach ben David. They are two different people from different tribal families. They live at the same time. Mashiach ben Joseph never takes the throne, nor is he entitled to. Mashiach ben Joseph is a warrior. Mashiach ben Joseph would also appear to be. Mashiach ben Joseph will be killed in battle and will be first to be raised up from the dead by Mashiach ben David. Wow. So there will be a lot of false images happening in the skies and false healing. So Satan cannot raise the dead himself. So it will be fake. So if Donald Trump had to die, then when he comes back to life, it will be fake one, because Satan cannot resurrect the dead. The period from which Mashiach ben Joseph first comes into prominence until he is resurrected after the Mashiach ben David comes to Israel is very short. They say it's the longest period is under 2 years. Now the basic chronology of the events is there is a 7 year period. Now most of you deny that the tribulation is 7 years. You just say it is 3.5 years. But the Jews believe it is a period of 7 years. It starts with continual problems, it starts to improve, and then in the 6th year it getting worse again. In the 7th year they say there are great wars. We all know about Gog and Magog that is coming, in which the Messiah Ben Joseph is first successful, and then he's been killed. Of course, that is before the tribulation started. That is World War III. Many Jews possibly will become depressed and fall away. At the end of the seven years, Mashiach ben David comes and finishes the job, and there comes the resurrection of the dead. We all know that Jesus will return then as the glorious king, and he will defeat the enemies towards the end. And the false messiahs, both the false prophet and the Antichrist, will be cast alive. Read Revelation 20. They are cast alive. They are cast alive. Many people say, yeah, no, the Antichrist will kill the false prophet. That is not the case. Don't know from which school of thought that comes from, but the Bible says that both of them are alive when they have been thrown into the lake of fire. Yes. So are you saved? Are you backslidden? Then get back into the ark now. Forgiveness is valid only on earth, and there are no more opportunities for those who die. Repent now. Give your heart to Jesus. And please help me to share this video. Please like it, share it, and subscribe. And do not forget to press the notification button. God bless you, everyone.